chairs, and I hope all the presenters are here.
So welcome. So we have 8 talks in this session. This is about CT and science education. I'm Madhavan from Chennai Mathematical Institute. So the first presentation is on analysis of food components based on computational thinking. So we have the authors are Raja Azad, Brajendra Singh Yadav, Aarti Sahu from the Jayaprakash Narayan Sarvodaya Vidyalaya in Danaru. Thank you. Good afternoon, all of you. मेरा नाम राजा भादुसर सिंह आज़ाद और मेरे सहयोगी विजय सिंह यादव और मेरी साथ में सहयोगी हैं श्रीमती आरती साहू. आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है वो है फूड एनालिसिस बेस ऑफ कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग. हम अपने खाना जो खाते हैं भोजन करते हैं उसमें जो चैप्टर है हमारे क्लास 6 का जो पहला ही चैप्टर है भोजन के घटक. आप लोगों को हिंदी कोई प्रॉब्लम तो है नहीं क्योंकि मैं हम लोग हिंदी मीडियम से. तो सबसे बड़े हमारा आज का जो हम चर्चा करेंगे कि कैसे हमने बच्चों को भोजन के घटकों को समझाने के लिए एक नई तकनीकों को ईजाद किया है जिससे कि हम बच्चों को आसानी से ये समझा सकते हैं कि भोजन के घटक क्या होते हैं, भोजन हम जो करते हैं उसमें कौन कौन से घटक होते हैं. बेसिकली कक्षा 6 के छात्रों के साथ जब वो आते हैं साइंस पढ़ते हैं तो उनको भोजन के बारे में तो जानकारी थी, पर जब हमने उनको भोजन के घटक के बारे में बताया तो वो थोड़ा सा उनके अंदर हिचकिचाहट कह सकते हैं या उनको समझ में नहीं आ रहा था ये चीज़ें होती क्या हैं. तो उसको हमने समझाने के लिए हमने कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग का उपयोग किया. नेक्स्ट, तो कैसे हमने कक्षा में भोजन के घटकों को समझाने के लिए इम्प्लीमेंटेशन किया, जो हमने तकनीक बनाई कि किस तरीके से हम कक्षा में छात्रों को पढ़ाएंगे. तो जब हम कक्षा में छात्रों को पढ़ाने का हम लोगों ने प्रयास किया कि किस तरीके से हम समझाएँ कि उनको समझ में आ जाए, जब हम उनको क्लास में पढ़ाते हैं बोर्ड में भोजन के 5 घटक प्रोटीन वसा कार्बोहाइड्रेट विटामिन खनिज लवण इन सबको हमने एक भोजन की थाली के रूप में लिखना होता है जिससे कि बच्चों को समझ में आ जाए कि जो हम खाना खाते हैं ये 5 पोषक पदार्थ वो हमारे खानों में होते हैं, खाने में होते हैं. तो बच्चों को थोड़ा सा इंटरेस्टिंग लगा, मनोरंजक लगा कि जो सर हमें समझा रहे थे कि हम जो डेली का खाना खाते हैं ये हमारी थाली में भोजन की थाली में भी होता है. नेक्स्ट, इसके बाद फिर हमने बच्चों से पूछा कि खाना क्यों खाते हैं, किस लिए खाते हैं. ये क्वेश्चन उनके पास नहीं थे, पर हमने उनसे एक क्वेश्चन पूछा कि आप जब खाना खाते हैं तो किस तरीके से खाते हैं. तो उन्होंने बताया कि हम अपने हाथ की उंगलियों की सहायता से खाना को लेते हैं. तो बस हमने उनसे कहा जिस तरीके से आप खाना खाते हैं हमारे हाथ में 5 उंगलियाँ होती हैं और 5 ही हमारे पोषक तत्व होते हैं, पदार्थ होते हैं. और फिर हम लोगों ने उनके साथ एक एक्टिविटी की और इस तरीके से हमने फिंगर्स कवर बनाए और हर एक फिंगर के ऊपर हमने हर घटक का नाम लिखा और इसी तरीके से छात्रों के साथ हम लोगों ने मिलकर एक एक्टिविटी की जिससे कि सारे बच्चों ने इस तरीके से एक्टिविटी में साथ ली करके और सारे कंपाउंड्स जो भोजन के घटक थे उससे वो रूबरू हुए. उनके नाम जो उनको लेने में परेशानी हो रही थी उनके लिए टफ हो रहा था कि किस तरीके से हम उनको जानेंगे समझेंगे. और इस तरीके की एक्टिविटी के लिए छात्रों ने बड़ी उत्सुकता के साथ, क्योंकि कक्षा 5 से जब वो बच्चे 6 में आते हैं तो भोजन के घटकों से परिचय होना उनके लिए थोड़ा सा टफ था. इस प्रकार से हमने सारे छात्रों के साथ मिलके एक एक्टिविटी की है और उनको बताया है कि जब हम खाना खाते हैं और खाने को हम अपने वाइट्स को जब पकड़ते हैं तो वो वाइट्स हमें इंडिकेट करते हैं, 5 फिंगर्स हमें इंडिकेट कर रही हैं कि ये 5 चीज़ें जो हैं वो भोजन में होनी चाहिए जब हम उसको खाना को खा रहे हैं. और ये जो खाने को हम अपने मुंह तक ला रहे हैं वो बता रहा है कि आपको ये पांचों पोषक पदार्थ, पांचों घटक आपके अंदर आने चाहिए। ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ होती है, इसलिए कि आपको लर्न भी करना है कि बेसिकली छात्र भूल जाते हैं कि भोजन के घटक कितने होते हैं, उनके नाम्स क्या होते हैं। हमारा मेन पर्पज़ ये था कि बच्चों को भोजन के घटकों से रूबरू कराना और उनको लर्न कराना, उनको समझ में आ जाए कि वो भोजन में होते हैं, इसलिए हमने इस प्रकार की एक्टिविटी अपनी कक्षा में कराई। तो इससे काफ़ी अच्छा बच्चों ने इसमें प्रतिभाग किया और काफ़ी अच्छी चीज़ें रहीं। नेक्स्ट सर,
इस एक्टिविटी को करने में या जो स्टूडेंट्स में शेयर करने में जो चैलेंजेस आए, तो उसमें हम लोगों ने देखा कि एक्चुअली जो मेरा विद्यालय है वो सोशल वेलफेयर डिपार्टमेंट से और एससी एसटी के स्टूडेंट उसमें पढ़ाई करते हैं और वो भी जो है बिलो पॉवर्टी लाइंस को बिलोंग करते हैं और दे इंडिकेट्स एक्चुअली वो विलेजेस को भी बिलोंग्स करते हैं। तो क्या है कि हमें इस वे में समझाने का, मतलब ये सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज था कि किस वे में हम इसको कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड्स को कैसे समझाएं, किस तरीके से समझाएं कि आसानी से जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं वो उसमें इन्वॉल्व हो के और आसानी से उस टॉपिक्स को समझ सकें।
नेक्स्ट,
जब हम लोगों ने हाथों की उंगलियों के माध्यम से बच्चों को इस एक्टिविटी के माध्यम से बच्चों को समझाया, तो इससे उनकी समझ, उनको बहुत जल्दी समझ में आ गया। होता है ना कि एक्टिविटी, किसी भी एक्टिविटी के माध्यम से बच्चों को कठिन से कठिन चीज़ बहुत आसानी से ही आ जाती है। उसके बाद जब छात्रों के लिए हम लोगों ने उस लेसन का टेस्ट लिया क्विज़ के माध्यम से, प्रश्न के माध्यम से, तो 99% बच्चों ने बहुत अच्छा आउटपुट दिया, बहुत अच्छे से उनको वो लेसन समझ में आया। तो इसके जरिए हम लोगों को ये पता चला कि अगर हम किसी भी टॉपिक में सीटी का यूज़ करते हैं या मतलब कुछ इस तरह से बच्चों को समझाते हैं तो बच्चे बहुत आसानी से इसको समझ सकते हैं। एंड एट लास्ट आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू सीएस पाठशाला एंड टीसीएस टीम आल्सो कि उन्होंने हम लोगों को ये ऐसा प्लेटफॉर्म दिया कि जिससे हम लोग बहुत नई चीज़ें सीख सकते हैं और उसको अपने विद्यालय में भी इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं, बच्चों में भी इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं, और इससे बहुत अच्छा है ये हम लोगों के विद्यालय के लिए। थैंक यू।
जैसे आपने अभी फूड कंटेंट्स के बारे में बताया,
yes,
तो मैक्सिमम क्या होता है कि अगर जब भी आप किसी क्लास में बड़े बच्चे के भी पास जाते हैं या छोटे बच्चे के,
yes,
कि फूड का फंक्शन क्या है,
yes,
तो मैंने, मेरे बच्चे भी हैं जो बड़े,
yes,
हैं,
yes,
तो सिर्फ एनर्जी ऐसे ही आता है, लेकिन जैसे आप देखो कि प्रोटीन्स तो,
yes,
जो अपने पार्ट्स या टिश्यू
डैमेज,
yes, तो ऐसा कुछ आपका प्लान है क्या, क्योंकि इसकी भी बहुत ज़रूरत है।
यस मैम, यस बिल्कुल बिल्कुल मैम, एक्चुअली क्या है, ये लेसन ख़त्म नहीं हुआ है, ये सिर्फ एक इंट्रोडक्शन है फूड ऑफ कंपाउंड्स। एक्चुअली क्या, अभी हम सोर्स ऑफ कंपाउंड्स पे गए ही नहीं है, लेक्स ऑफ कंपाउंड, उनकी कंपाउंड्स कमी से क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स होंगी। अभी हमारा सिर्फ और सिर्फ इस टॉपिक एफटेक को लिखने का एक था कि कक्षा सिक्स के बच्चों को या फिफ्थ के बच्चों को पहली हमारी प्राथमिकता ये थी कि बच्चों को हम कंपाउंड्स के नाम ही लर्न करा दें या भोजन में होता क्या है, क्या होना चाहिए। फिर उसके बाद नेक्स्ट जो हमारा जो पर्पज़ रहेगा या हम उसको समझाने का तरीका रहेगा कि अगर हम उस कंपाउंड्स कम करते हैं या बैलेंस डाइट नहीं लेते हैं तो उसमें क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स होंगी, वो हम नेक्स्ट लेवल पर ले जाएंगे। अभी सिर्फ हम लोग एक कह सकते हैं प्राइमरी एक स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट में कि उनको बच्चों को साइंस सब्जेक्ट से रिलेट कराना, उनके अंदर एक रुचि प्रकट करना कि जिससे कि उनको लगे कि नहीं साइंस सब्जेक्ट को भी हम बहुत अच्छे से पढ़ सकते हैं। ये इसलिए पूरा चैप्टर हमने भी इसमें कंप्लीट नहीं किया है, सिर्फ और सिर्फ हमने भोजन के घटकों को ही एक्सप्लेन किया है। नो 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 मैं कलर्स नहीं, क्योंकि हम लोग यहाँ पे फिंगर्स का यूज कर रहे थे, सिर्फ कलर्स नहीं, यहाँ पे हम फिंगर्स को आइडेंटिटी कर रहे थे। और फिंगर्स हमारा कोई भी फिंगर्स, मतलब फाइव फिंगर्स हैं, फाइव कंपाउंड हैं। नो 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 वो तो हमने थोड़ा सा एक्टिविटी को कलरफुल करने के लिए, नो नहीं नहीं नहीं, क्योंकि बेसिकली क्या है, हमने फिंगर्स उपयोग कर रहे हैं, खाना भी हम फिंगर्स की हेल्प से ले रहे हैं, तो उसमें कलर्स नहीं है। आपको लर्न करना है, ऐसा हम पर्टिकुलर इंडिकेट नहीं कर सकते ना कि ये प्रोटीन्स हैं या कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स है, ऐसा नहीं है। ये सिर्फ ये बता रहा है कि हम खाना डेली खाते हैं, लेकिन हमारे बच्चों को यही नहीं पता होता है कि हम खाने में हमारे होने क्या चीज़ें, और हम ये डेली करते हैं ये खाने की जो है, चाहे आप स्पून से लें किसी से लें, कि हमारे पाँचों फिंगर्स ही उसका यूज करते हैं, इसलिए।
थैंक यू,
थैंक 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 थैंक।
सो आवर सेकंड प्रेजेंटेशन इज केमिस्ट्री क्रॉनिकल्स अनवेलिंग फन फॉली टेक्निक्स। द ऑथर्स आर शिवजीत सिंह, श्याम तिवारी, उपेंद्र पाल, फ्रॉम द राजकीय आश्रम पढ़ाई इंटर कॉलेज हरदौली बांदा।
Should we start? Yeah. First of all, good afternoon, everyone, all over present over here. My name is Shivji Singh. We are from Rajki Ashrampati Inter College, Hardoli Banda, main district in UP. Right? I'm author one. My name is Shivji Singh, and author two that is Shyam Tiwari, and author three is Upendra Pal. Right? So the topic, name of our topic is Chemistry Chronicle Unveiling Fun Folly Techniques. So before starting, first of all, I would like to thank you to CS Pathshala and the ICER community and CTIS team for giving us the platform over here. So let's start with our topic, right? Move on to the next slide. So first of all, I would like to wipe out the first myth that this presentation that we are representing over here is not more of algorithm based, right? It is more of presentation, it is more of logical thinking, it is more of how you can inculcate the interest among the students for the get into the computational thinking in the subject, right? Basically, first of all, I will like to first slide, my first slide is challenges, because as soon as I move on to the further presentation, I like you to know that from where we have started, what the grassroots level is, right? So our we are from the same school, Rajki Ashrampati Inter College. It is a school basically for socially and economically deprived student, right? They lack the basic education, their foundation are so very weak that if you can say that even in the class 6th and 7th standard, some of you will some students don't are not legible enough to read and write and all. So we are working at a very hard pace to inculcate the spirit of computational thinking in them, right? So our topic is basically on the subject chemistry, right? Chemistry, as we all know, this student also know that it is a in 11th and 12th there it's considered as a monotonous subject, right? Students don't take keen interest on the chemistry because it is more of reaction based, it is more of theoretical concepts, more of definitions, and also is one way or the other that students some after learning it for one or two hours for the same classes, they will they get distracted, right? Their the continuity of the mind that do not get settles down. So how we can input CTIS in computational thinking in it and make it more interesting? So this is all our about presentation is. So for that we have introduced few methods. The first one is next slide. So first is that what we are using is molecular simulation, and through that molecular simulation we have introduced the game, right? And that game is basically that from that simple game we will learn to balance the chemical equation, right? So that chemical simulation is designed through the link. Yeah, next slide. Yeah, ma'am, can you put up the slide? So this game is basically just to design that if a student is learning the balancing, and that is also a boring topic, but if it is learning through some game, then how interesting it becomes, right? So this is how all about. So firstly, then we move on to the game, sir. Can we move back? Actually, this game that we have designed, that game is designed, it is of three levels, right? First level is for easy, then we have introduced level two, that moderate, level three, that is hard. So yeah, just click on the games icon. Yeah, as you click it, Yeah. Then we have a three stages. Level 1 for easy. Level 2 is for moderate. Level 3 is hard. So how this game works, I'm just showing you the very short synopsis of it. So in level 1, yeah, click on it. So level 1, like see, we have a very simpler molecular equation here. Yeah, that is NO, N2, and O2, right? So if a student is showing some random number, if he is increasing this number, click on it. He is writing 1 over here, and and if it increase this number by 1 or 2 something, and if you check that, let's check that reaction is balanced or not. Then when you click on this check icon, right? When we click on this check icon, it shows that reaction is not balanced, right? Now why it is not balanced? That is some algorithm student have to think about. So through this game he will also get to know that why this algorithm is not, that why this reaction is not balanced. So we have shown it by that small fun game that you use now, that ladder uplift down. So when you click on it, so you can see why it is not balanced. So in a product side we have 4 nitrogen, in a left side 1. So there is not a balanced thing is there, that tilted thing is. So basically that I'm not teaching you the how balancing is done, I'm teaching you that how interesting it becomes when it comes to a game level, when molecular game level, that student get to know. And now since our foundation is very weak for the student, we don't get into the algorithm that how this game is working. Right. If you go on to the algorithm, there is a pattern that that in the where LHS is matching with RHS, there is amount of nitrogen. If you go on to programming level, that is a different slightly thing. But we are introducing this logical approach that how you can go to the balancing and all. This is our first method of teaching. Then moving on to the next. See, today, as we know, this that is pathway mapping. Now what this pathway mapping is, that suppose if we teach some reaction to the student or some conversion, that for simple example if we take that for class 11th and 12th level, that if we are converting ethanol to suppose ethanoic acid, right? I said the student that convert this. So how many reaction you will take place? So he will learn that firstly we will oxidize it with this method and then follow. So this reaction will follow 3 or 4 steps. Now when students get to know it, it become monotonous for them that yeah, I have to learn 5 reactions. Now how I can memorize it, and in the exam time how we can represent it? So that becomes a burdensome. Now if the student can map out in a logical way that in a different pattern that how this reaction goes on, and it can dictate it. Now how he can learn it in a very particular way is that, as we know that at the present scenario, students are more of afflicted towards reel making in shorts in mobiles, are more of the teachers also do that. Yeah, in their spare time you form the reel and all. So why not introduce this reel making concept into this our education? No. So what have we did it? We asked the student that yeah, we taught this reaction, we simplified that in a certain mapping part, and we told them that now you have to represent the entire concept in the reel formation. Now that reel should be, now you can add background music to it, now you label many thing over it to make it more interesting. So I have attached some reel here of the student that we have practiced in this our classroom in our school. So next slide. Yeah, this is how the reaction, one of our student has formed the mapping. He's mapped the entire concept of some reaction in a different section, and he has narrated the entire concept into the form of a flowchart sequence in the next video embedded over it. Since the video is not working, I have earlier tried it in the here. So what you can got the concept what I am telling you, that in this entire video he is narrating the entire sequence in a logical manner, and when the student did that, the entire pattern goes on to their mind. Now embedded that yeah, this step happened. So then he get recognized over it, that it get memorized over it in a very short and quick way, and it is retained for a very long time. So that helps out the student in the thinking and all. The next method that we have introduced is molecular simulation. Since time is running out, so I will not go on with very detail of it. It is a very simple thing, is that through the animation and through the modular concept, we have made an animation over it, but I'm not going into it because of short span of time. There are certain bond angles we have designed, and through that animation we can move the bond angles, right? Now how it helps, it helps the student to visualize the thing in 3-dimensional in a very impactful way, and so that he could, when we come to the higher level of reactions, that how the nucleophile is approaching, how the electrophile is approaching, then it helps to visualize that how the things are going on, right? Then moving on to the next method. Sir, don't click it. Moving on to the next thing. Yeah, the next is that chemical puzzle. It is a simple thing that we have formed some puzzles of chemistry, right? See, in a higher standard, the puzzles don't sound so much interesting, but yeah, it still inculcates students to learn something, right? So we have designed a simple gridlock challenge for the student. Like if we have to teach them the number of proton, number of neutron, number of electron, right? And we have first of all given this the unlock grid. The student first of all have to fill this table, so that student can easily do it by filling the number of proton, neutron, and electron, and then going on to the grid challenge. Next slide. Yeah, now we will give this that grid challenge to the student, and now student use this grid challenge by the earlier previous table that is given to them and fill the all the blocks over here. Still I'm not going into detailing due to the short of time. Yeah, next slide. Now I'm coming on to the impact, how it is impacted our students, right? See, from the those that are very low grassroots levels, it has impacted those students in a broader way, that now they are getting more interested in chemistry. They have their incrosity, their logical thinking, and the cognitive development that happens into them. That has also inbuilted at a very high strength. So it has helped impacted our students a very lot. And that is due to this, our students have achieved a very lot. To the last slide. In the block and in the CISR that our students have participated from the so very basic level, students have participated in the National Science Model Level Competition, and you will be very astonished to know that they have built a vehicle that runs via water, right? Through the water electrolysis mechanism, they have run it and they've made it, and we got the prize for the same and all. That is the district level science model competition we have made. So this cognitive development, this is how computational thinking helps our student. So this is, and at the last, I will finish it by thanking again to the CIS team and all for giving us this platform to showcase you the same. Thank you.
We have time for one quick question.
Sorry?
They run in a browser or is it an app?
No, they run in a browser, right? But that simulations, we have done some modification over it so that it becomes a very easy for the students to go on it. We also want to teach the algorithm how this game is working. But since the students are a very basic foundation, so we still have to maintain, we have to go with their standard and all. So that is the thing. Any more questions? Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
So the third presentation in the session is a study of magnet and its properties using computational thinking by Vishal Nayak. And I will let him introduce the school name because I can't pronounce it.
Good afternoon, everyone. मेरा नाम विशाल नायक है. मैं सलोजी नामोड़ा प्राइमरी स्कूल गांधीनगर गुजरात से हूँ. तो मैग्नेट्स और उसके प्रॉपर्टीज़ को हमने कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग को अप्लाई करके उसको स्टडी किया है. तो क्लास सिक्स में ये चैप्टर आता है फन विद द मैग्नेट्स. तो वहाँ पे मैग्नेट्स की कौन सी प्रॉपर्टीज़ है उसको किस तरह से समझ सकते और किस तरह से पैटर्न्स को आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते उसमें यहाँ पर हमने फ्लो चार्ट एनालिसिस बेस को अप्लाई किया हुआ है. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. तो स्टूडेंट्स जब भी मैग्नेट्स के बारे में सुनते तो इस तरह के बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन उनके मन में आते. पहला क्वेश्चन यही होता है कि ये हमेशा अट्रैक्ट क्यों करता है वो उनके, और वो ये सोचते हैं कि हमारे पास अगर खुद का मैग्नेट हो तो वो ज़्यादा प्ले कर सके. तो उन्होंने क्लासरूम में बहुत सारी एक्टिविटीज़ को फॉलो किया था जिसमें मटेरियल्स को कलेक्ट करना, उस मटेरियल्स में से कौन सा मटेरियल्स मैग्नेटाइज है नॉन मैग्नेटाइज है उसको आइडेंटिफाई करना, फिर मैग्नेट्स हमेशा कौन सी डायरेक्शंस में अलाइन रहता है वो देखना, उसके पोल्स क्या है उसमें किस में रिपल्सन हो रहा है किस में अट्रैक्शन हो रहा है उसको आइडेंटिफिकेशन करना, और हर एक मैग्नेट का पर्टिकुलर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैटर्न होता है उसे किस तरह से उसको ऑब्जर्व किया जा सकता है. तो यहाँ पे 3 मैग्नेट्स यूज़ किए हुए, बार मैग्नेट्स है, एक टूटा हुआ मैग्नेट है और सिलेंड्रिकल मैग्नेट है. तीनों को थ्रेड से बांध के वो पर्टिकुलर किस डायरेक्शंस में स्टेडी होता है वो फाइंड करके उनके रिजल्ट को कंपेयर किया है, और सेकंड वन में किस में रिपल्सन हो रहा है किस में अट्रैक्शन हो रहा है कौन सा पोल्स ये कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स कर रहा है उसका ये ऑब्जर्वेशन उन्होंने किया है. अब हर एक मैग्नेट का जो पर्टिकुलर मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पैटर्न होता है उसको फाइंड करने के लिए उन्होंने आयरन पाउडर को यूज़ किया है, और डिफरेंट शेप के मैग्नेट्स को जैसे अप्लाई किया तो इस तरह की जो इमेजेस डेवलप हुई वो देख के वो बहुत खुश हो गए थे, क्योंकि उनके लिए सब नया था। अब ये पूरी स्टडी करने के लिए उन्होंने ये फ्लो चार्ट को एनालिसिस किया था। तो इसका थ्री मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव है, मटेरियल्स को कलेक्ट करना, उस मटेरियल्स में एक हिडन मैग्नेट रखा हुआ है उसको फाइंड करना, और उसके जो पोल्स है वो पोल्स को आइडेंटिफाई करना। तो मैग्नेट की हेल्प से उनके पास जो मटेरियल्स है उसमें मैग्नेटाइज और नॉन मैग्नेटाइज में उनको डीकम्पोज कर दिया। अब इस मैग्नेटाइज मटेरियल में कौन सा मटेरियल ऐसा है जिसमें अट्रैक्शन भी हो रहा है और रिपल्सन भी हो रहा है वो उन्हें फाइंड करना है। उस एनालिसिस के बेस पे उन्होंने मैग्नेट को जो हिडन है वो फाइंड कर दिया। अब उन्हें ये चेक करना है कि उस मैग्नेट के पोल्स पर मार्क किया हुआ है या नहीं है, क्योंकि कुछ मैग्नेट्स को हमने टैप कवर करके उसके पोल्स को हाइड कर दिया था। तो वो फाइंड करके अगर पोल्स मार्क किए हुए तो सीधा वो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक को स्टडी करेंगे, अगर पोल्स पे मार्क नहीं किया हुआ है तो दूसरे मैग्नेट्स की हेल्प से वहाँ पे अट्रैक्शन हो रहा है या रिपल्सन हो रहा है वो देख के वो एन पोल है या एस पोल है वो इजीली फाइंड कर सकते हैं। तो यहाँ पे हमने सिटी के जो कंपोनेंट्स है उसमें डीकम्पोजिशन और एब्स्ट्रैक्शन मटेरियल्स को मैग्नेटाइज और नॉन मैग्नेटाइज में डिवाइड करने में अप्लाई किया है। पैटर्न रिकॉग्निशन, जो मैग्नेट की जो प्रॉपर्टीज है कि उसके कितने पोल्स होते हैं, अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्सन किस तरह से होता है, कौन सी डायरेक्शंस में ऑनलाइन होता है उसमें अप्लाई किया है, और जो फ्लो चार्ट एनालिसिस है उसमें हमने अल्गोरिदम को उन्होंने अप्लाई किया हुआ है। तो प्रीवियस जो एक्टिविटीज़ की उस एक्टिविटीज़ को फाइंड करके जो रिजल्ट्स उन्हें मिले उन सबको कंपेयर करके मैग्नेट की प्रॉपर्टीज में कौन सी पैटर्न्स है, तो उन्होंने ये फाइंड किया कि फॉर ईच मैग्नेट वहाँ पे टू पोल्स होते हैं, नॉर्थ पोल साउथ पोल्स, लाइक पोल्स में हमेशा रिपल्सन होता है, अनलाइक पोल्स में अट्रैक्शन होता है, और जो भी मैग्नेट्स है उसका डायरेक्शन नॉर्थ टू साउथ अलाइन होता है। तो यहाँ पे हमने कंपैरिजन बतावे कि जब भी पहले हम ट्रेडिशनल मेथड्स अप्लाई करते थे तो वहाँ पे उन्हें बहुत सारा मेमोराइज करना पड़ता था, तो मेमोराइज करने की वजह से उनकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग्स बहुत डीप नहीं हो पा रही थी, इसलिए वो बहुत सारी जो एक्टिविटीज़ है वो स्किप कर देते थे, और एग्ज़ाम में जो भी लॉजिक बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस आते हैं वो उनको सॉल्व नहीं कर पा रहे थे। तो यहाँ सीटी अप्लाई करने के बाद जो स्टेप बाय स्टेप इंस्ट्रक्शन होता है एल्गोरिदम को, उसको फॉलो करने से उनका अंडरस्टैंडिंग्स क्लियर हुआ, जिसकी वजह से वो बहुत सारी एक्टिविटीज़ में वेरी ईगरली पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे थे, और जो भी पैटर्न है उसे किस तरह से फाइंड किया जा सकता है, किस तरह से अप्लाई किया फाइंड किया जा सकता है वो उन्होंने ढूंढा। और सबसे मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट है कि एग्ज़ाम में जो भी लॉजिकल बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस आते एप्लीकेशन बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस आते वो अटेम्प्ट कर पाते थे, और सीटी की मदद से जो मेन स्किल है रीजनिंग और अप्रोच, जो हमारे यहाँ पे गुजरात में बहुत सारी कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्ज़ाम आती है स्कॉलरशिप के लिए, तो उसमें उनका काफ़ी इम्प्रूवमेंट मिला है। थैंक यू। रिंग मैग्नेट के लिए दो मेथड है, एक तो आपके पास अगर बार मैग्नेट है उसको रिंग मैग्नेट के पास ले जाओ तो वो भी वहाँ पे अट्रैक्शन हो रहा है रिपल्स हो रहा है वो आपको आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं। दूसरे पैटर्न ये है कि उसको आपको थ्रेड से हैंग करो, ठीक है, तो वो हाँ रिंग मैग्नेट को बांध दो, टैप से भी बांध सकते हो आप, या दो रिंग मैग्नेट को साथ में रखो तो उसका थिकनेस बढ़ जाएगा, फिर उसको टैप से बांध टैप अलाइन करके दूरी से बांध दो, तो फिर वो नॉर्थ पोल जो उसका होगा वो नॉर्थ साइड में रहेगा, साउथ पोल साइड साइड में रहेगा।
ठीक है, आपने कह रहे हैं कि रिंग मैग्नेट ऐसे होता है, समझो ऐसे होता है ना, इधर
मतलब नॉर्थ पोल टू साउथ पोल,
ओके, इधर इधर पोल आता है, तो रिंग मैग्नेट टूट गया तो पोल कहाँ होता है?
रिंग मैग्नेट तो यू शेप मैग्नेट बन जाएगा ना।
तो उस मतलब आपने सिर्फ बार मैग्नेट की बात किया तो
रिंग मैग्नेट में आपको बोला ना रिंग मैग्नेट में उनको है
आपके एक्टिविटी में कैसे बदल लेंगे वो दूसरे टाइप मैग्नेट
अगर
रिंग मैग्नेट या वो
हमने यहाँ पे तो जो तीन मैग्नेट्स दिए थे उनको उस पोल्स को फाइंड करने के लिए पूछो ना आप सर। हाँ वहाँ पे उन्होंने एनालिसिस तीन बेस पर जो सिलेंड्रिकल मैग्नेट बार मैग्नेट है और जो टूटा हुआ मैग्नेट है उसके बेस पे उनको ने कंपेयर किया था, वहाँ पे उन्होंने वो स्टडीज़ नहीं की थी कि आपके पास अगर रिंग मैग्नेट्स है तो उसको किस तरह से फॉलो करना है, लेकिन ये मेथड से आप अप्लाई कर सकते हो।
The next presentation is CT in Learning Components of Food by Archana Vati from B.R. Ambedkar Gurukulam, Patnapatna.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm so glad to present my presentation here. I'm Archana from AP's Very Schools, Patnapatnam, Srikakulam. Coming to the topic, Introduction of CT in Learning Science. Components of Food is the first lesson. In class 6, we need to explain the students from nutrients, ingredients, till deficiency diseases. Children knew that we get food from plants and animals, and food gives us energy, it makes us to grow. But they don't know which part of food is giving energy and which makes us to grow. I used some ads like Glucovita Bowls and ECC Cricketers ad, Horlicks and Pediasure for the children to introduce about nutrients. Then I gave some examples. For example, rice and sweet potato are rich sources of energy and we get carbohydrates from them, and milk, meat and pulses gives us proteins. So one student in the class observed that while cutting peeled potatoes, when their mother cutting peeled potatoes, she observed a white precipitate on the chopping board. Asked me, she is telling that it may be starch, madam. Like that, she asked me. I replied her, yes, it is starch. Then another girl asked me, how can we say that it is a starch or it is a carbohydrate, ma'am? Then I explained about confirmation test for the presence of nutrients. Then already the nutrients were decomposed as carbohydrates, protein, starch. Coming to the confirmation test, I decomposed each step sequentially and explained them about the confirmation test, and I conducted this activity in the classroom. All the students performed this activity, and even a future learner girl also performing the test as a magic. Okay, then another girl given an example that while her mother processing the beans to prepare curry, she observed fine strands. So she thought that the beans are examples to fibers like moringa and okra. Students go for their real life situation and asking about the nutrients. Actually, we are using this computational thing or analysis, data analysis in mathematics. Now it is clear for them that this analysis or data analysis is applicable to basic sciences also. It is not only applicable to mathematics, measurements or calculations, it is also applicable to basic sciences. One girl, while her mother churning buttermilk, she observed butter is floating on the surface of the buttermilk. And it is an example for it is sticky and it makes the paper translucent. So as the buttermilk we are getting from the milk is an example for fats. And the remaining girls, this girl is telling whatever she wants. Ma'am told that it is a protein, but this girl is telling that it's a example for fat. Then I replied, both of us are correct. Milk contain proteins, fats along with loads of calcium. So now student understood that more than one nutrients are present in the same ingredient. It made the students to analyze the data, and they confirmed that more than one nutrient are present in the same ingredient. Then while explaining about the confirmation test, I sequentially decomposed and I made an algorithm for the ruddy reckoner. Actually, all our students are from very rural background. We need to explain them everything. They don't know proper food habits. We need to tell them everything in the school. From alphabets to sometimes we use it to tell them alphabets in the class 5. Such as students, now they are analyzing the whole ingredients they are taking in a day, and they playfully learning about the nutrients. If a girl in that class is pale and she is weak, then they are asking that girl to take a HB test in the school dispensary and take extra peanut chakis and ragi malt and other supplements to her, and asking her to take a HB test in the dispensary and suggesting that girl, the health supervisor, give some iron folic acid tablets to that girl. So these girls are implementing the whatever they learned in their day-to-day life situations. And parents are getting some ingredients like rice pulses from the government. Actually, these parents are selling the pulses, red gram dal they are getting from the government, and they are selling the red gram dal to the nearby shops or to the neighbors for money. Now these girls are learned about balanced diet, and they are insisting their mother not to sell these ingredients to the shops and prepare dal and vegetable curries in the home, and you also take that. Actually, they are taking, most of the parents are working as a labor in agriculture fields and construction sites. They will take rice and hot starch solution or any pickle for lunch. So these girls are now insisting parents and suggesting parents about the balanced diet. Now coming to the impact, students understand about the deficiency diseases, their symptoms, and they are well aware of balanced diet. Okay, now as a teacher, we need to use this CT for our professional career, and CT, introduction of CT in classroom activity, will elevate the student and make the students to use it in their daily life situations. Thank you one and all.
Any questions?
Maybe you could also play some games with the students, asking them things like, if somebody...
Madam, actually, in the dining hall, all the students take food at a time only. Meanwhile, when in the curry is carrot, oh girl, today it is vitamin A curry. Like that, they are playing in that only. So...
Right, superb. Yeah, okay. I was going to suggest something similar. Maybe guess the ingredient.
Guess the ingredient like that. They are playing in the classroom, and evening snacks also. If we give fried poha in the evening, they capture that poha in a paper plate or a paper. They collect from raw poha from the mess, and they search for the translucency test for fat presence of test. Wow. They play like that. Thank you everyone. Thank you,
sir. So the next presentation is on acids, bases, and salts. Polupalli, Venkata, Aruna, Lakshmi, is it on online?
No.
Only Parvati is on.
Okay. It's mixed up here then. Because there is...
They're not there.
Okay, anyway. So we'll then skip this and go to the next one then. So the next one is on the use of CT skills in magnetic farming by Namrata Jarudkar and Anita Wankhede. They're from the School of Scholars, Beltarudi.
Good afternoon, everyone.
My name is Namrata Zarudkar and my co-author.
My name is Anita Vankhede.
We are from School of Scholars, Beltarodi, Nagpur. We are presenting our research activity here on the topic Use of CT Skills in Magnetic Farming under the theme The CT Skills in Science Education. Next. As per the topic, it is based on the farming, and we are trying to integrate CT skills in farming. So why the CT in farming? When we are talking about integration of CT in the different field and we are talking about the farming, so it helped to optimize the farming practices by enabling the data with the help of, there are many data with the help of soil health, weather pattern, crop yield, and as well as it shows it is managing and monitoring the environmental impact through the different practices. Next.
Farmers faces many problems, but low crop yield is major concern for the farmers, and this is caused due to inadequate water retention and slow maturation. So our sixth standard students try to highlight these two main issues of farmers. And next. So students, they wonder, if magnets can help humans, why can't we use this magnet to grow the plant stronger and help farming challenges. Next. So we try to decompose this problem by breaking down the complex problem into smaller part, and by investigating sustainable farming technique, exploring potential of magnetic farming, and testing the impact of magnetic field on seed germination and plant growth. Next.
So when we are talking about the magnetic farming, what it is actually, it is simply that we are observing the plant growth under the controlled magnetic field. So for this, next. We have started with our experimentation. A student of standard 6, they have performed this activity in a group. Here our research methodology, it is a comparative study, and we have done this activity in the month of February for the, and observation is noted for the 15 days. Here the setup we require for the number of pots, in each set we require 3 pots, including the sowing of groundnut seeds, use of magnets, especially we have used the ring magnets here, and while doing the observation for the 15 days, the data collected and accordingly we have analysis is done. So you can see here the picture, they are working in a group. And in each set, we have done with the 3 pot. Here, pot A is with ring magnet. Pot B, where we are using the magnetized water. And pot C, here, this is the germination is done without any magnetic influence. So you can see the picture shows how we have arranged the seed in pot A. And when we are using the magnetized water for pot B, so simply we have taken the water in a glass and kept it on the magnet. So means we can easily check if you keep any iron thing like safety pin inside the water, so magnetic effect is passing through that water. So that magnetized water we use to water for the pot B, and pot C is without any magnetic influence. Next. So we have done this observation for the 15 days, and in data collection we have measured the growth in plant, as well as they have checked the moisture in soil for all the pot 3. And while checking the moisture, means for pot C, in the morning if they are watering, so next day they observe where the soil is looking dry. So it is while doing that activity, pot C we used to water it on daily basis, pot B alternate day, and pot A we found that it needs to water after 2 days. So it is showing that water retention in soil, and that is checked with the help of blotting paper. Next. So while doing that, by doing this observation for the checking the soil moisture, as moisture retention in soil and as well as growth in plant, then they have represented their finding with the help of graph. So you can see here with the help of bar graph is also some of them they have presented with the help of line graph. One bar showing pot A, pot B, and another that bar is showing for pot C. Next. So here it is abstracted that qualitative and quantitative growth is observed in pot A and B, which is with magnetic influence, whereas it is the expected result we could not get in pot C. Next. So this is the analysis which we have done. The accelerated and consistent growth we found in the group with magnetic influence, as well as more water retention in soil we could observe in the same group. Continue. This is the algorithm which we have followed, starting with the identification of problem, then their brainstorming, starting with the experimentation setup, observation, data collection, and finally come to the conclusion. So while doing any activity, definitely there are challenges, we are coming across the challenges. Here this is done in a group, this activity is performed in a group. So it is very important that each and every individual must get involved in the activity for the purpose of study. So for this we come across, means we have overcome with the problem by monitoring them in a group, peer understanding with each other, and it shows the fostering, it shows fostering supportive and inclusive learning environment. So we could try to come out of this. So finally we came to the conclusion that this use of computational thinking skill where we are integrating, so it is showing a transformative approach towards the agricultural practices. And when students have performed this experiment actually, so they also became confident that they are getting something different. Instead of, means the regular practices are there, but already they are studying this concept of magnetism in standard 6. So this is nothing but the application of magnetism when they started searching what can we do, some other things. So this is, they feel themselves very confident, as well as by applying such computational thinking skill like algorithm thinking, decomposition, abstraction. So there is a development of their thinking, problem solving thing, critical thinking, creativity. So this is what we have finally came to the conclusion with the help of this experimentation. So this is what our activity that we have done. Thank you. Yes.
इसको हम big scale पे use कर सकते हैं आपने soil का जो
बोला हाँ हाँ so yes
iron dust है तो क्या ऐसी कोई magnetic dust से हम ये use कर सकते हैं
no if you have to perform it on larger scale ना so it is better to use magnetized water magnetized water now this is we have done on the experimental basis, you know. If you have to perform on large scale, so with the help of passing electromagnetic field through the water in a pipe.
Yes,
yes. Hey, there is a.
It is followed in the foreign.
In foreign countries, huh? Yes, yes. Yeah, बिल्कुल. Yes, sir. एक्सपेरिमेंटल बेसिस विच वी हैव डन स्टूडेंट्स हैव डन सो डेफिनेटली इफ यू हैव टू परफॉर्म इट ऑन लार्ज स्केल सो वी नीड अ एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड नंबर ऑफ अदर थिंग्स आर ऑल्सो डेफिनेटली नीडेड टू मेक इट एज अ सक्सेसफुल इवेंट हाँ यस सर हाँ सेम
इट इज ऑलरेडी
नो बट हिज क्वेश्चन इज वो पॉट में रिस्ट्रिक्टेड एरिया है
हाँ हाँ हाँ
अगर वो बड़ा इसमें विल इट डिसिपेट
सो इट इज ऑब्वियसली इट विल वर्क बेटर
इट इज प्रैक्टिस्ड
हाँ अच्छा अच्छा इफेक्ट हाँ यस इफेक्ट विल बी सेम हाँ
I wanted to share
the size of the magnet. Is it depend on pod size or is it depend on size of
No, it is not depending on pod size. We have taken magnet, okay, that especially we have used the ring magnet, this much size, and they are having this much hole inside that. So hardly we have put 5 to 6 seeds in that. At that much only accommodate in that space.
Just wanted to share something. Like this magnetic water concept is there, no? So we are having articles in Ayurveda. So they are using this magnetic growing wheat crops small. And they grind that, and that is given to chronic patient. So it is used as a treatment.
Magnetic therapy is also there, and this magnetic water is also used for therapy.
Very surprising to me. Last year I came through that article that magnetic water is used to grow crops, and that water is used in the treatment of patient.
Yes.
So what does magnet does that? Like we know, what is water? It is H2O. So when magnets come in contact with that H2O, so it bifurcates it in H plus OH minus ion, and according to that, that plant growth is different,
faster.
And its contents are also different from regular water.
Yes, contents are different.
From regular water, so it undergoes reaction when we are putting that magnet.
Yes, and for plant also, means it is speeding up the formation of protein. So that's why it is eco-friendly also. No side effect. It is a sustainable practice. So we should look forward for this practice. Yes. Magnetic therapy and magnetic water, same. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. So the next presentation is Nurturing 21st Century Skills in Learning Science Using CT Skills. The presenters are Deepa Sharma and Sunita Maurya, again from School of Scholars, Beltharodi.
Good afternoon, everyone present over here. We are here presenting our topic, a research-based project on computational thinking, which basically revolve around 7 standard topic, that is light and reflection. So as we are aware, now modern world, the students should be equipped with number of competencies. So we integrated computational thinking and also fostered problem solving, inquiry based learning and competency based learning, and we integrated CT skills so that we can enhance the learning outcomes of this lesson. So the basic idea or the basic learning outcomes which we were expecting once we are done with the activity are investigating laws of reflection, solving the mirror maze, and reflecting on applications.
So the basic principle on which we have planned this lesson is like to develop all the activities are planned hand-on activities, and it is full-on engaging, where we are encouraging the observation, then reflection, and then application in the real world. So if you have seen here, the first step is learning how light reflects, right? So here the whole activity is designed in a way that students should do it by their own, by the help of a teacher, by the guidance of a teacher. So we have given a worksheet. Right. So this worksheet contains the questions and the guidance, like how to proceed the activity. So and the material which is used for the experimentation. So we have given the flashlight, mirrors, and the other material which is required, and we are guiding them. And then the students have done in the group. This activity was done in a group. So first, they have learned how the light behaves, like how it travels. So with the help of this, it's very easy to explore that light travels in a straight line. And when they are placing the mirror, they can identify that it can change the direction also when light falls on the mirrors, right? Based on that, the worksheet was given. So they have to draw the whatever they are observing. So they have drawn this number of observations, and based on that, then they have to define what is incidence ray, what is reflected ray, and what is normal. So this needs a lot of discussion in a classroom because this is very complex for a student to frame by themselves. So this way, like then they have done the observation and then they understand, they concluded that light travels in a straight line and whenever they hit any surface, it bounces back, especially the mirror, right? Next. So here you have seen, these are the worksheets they have done while the process of learning. And here the teacher is helping them out, right? Wherever they want any confusions, we are working because time was the limit for us. Yes, next.
So here, along with the activity, we also shown them the real life application where this laws of reflection are used in a city, in a small town of Norway. Actually, they are they don't get sunlight for 6 months in a year due to in winters basically. So due to developing engineering technologies and this application of laws of reflection, the engineers could divert the sunlight to the city center, by which the maximum population now feeling the warmth, light, everything of the sun because of this activity. So we have not only left this to this class level, we have asked them to analyze. So they could find ki by placing the mirrors in appropriate angles, they could direct the sunlight to the city, helping the people living in the city. So solving, based on it, they solved the mirror maze.
So the first step was exploration. So they just explore, they understand how light travels and behaves. Then the real life application, they have observed in reality, this reflection of light is working. And then we have given the mirror maze challenge. Again, this is a part of a worksheet where this layout we have given, only this diagram we have given, student have to create the model and they have to guide the light path to hit the target, like from the start point to the end target. You can see this bullseye here and they have to target it the way they want. Like it is not restricted ki yes in this specific direction. So they have already, so while doing this, they have done the decomposition because they have to just break down like how to create this maze, where to place what, right? Then placing the mirror and then fit pattern, as they have already seen the pattern, based on that only they have to see here, like where, what, at what angle they will place the flashlight so that the light, at what angle it will get reflected, and that way they have found the path. So, and they have created the simplified model by applying the abstraction. So there were two tasks. First, the model we have given, they have to create, they have to experience. And then the second task is every group has to create their own model, right? Like my group will create a mirror maze for this group. So everybody has tried, like many of their models were not successful, but few models were successful, right? So this is again here, decomposition, a pattern recognition and abstraction. This is the model which is created by the students. This is the start point and that is the end point. So from here, you have to place the flashlight and you have to target this bullseye. You have to target the bullseye using mirrors and the, so this was created by the students.
Now it is design solution. So these are the actual designs developed by the students. So this is the level 2 template. As explained by ma'am, it is given by us, the whole idea, how it will work. And the level 1 was to be created by the students. So here, students have compared the designs prepared. And based on this, the evaluating design solution. So in the task, we gave them actually minimum 2 to 3 models they have to create in which they should hit the bullseye.
2 to 3 ways they have to place a mirror so that we get the best out of it and the shortest distance wala story. So that, because we have to select the winners.
Yes.
Right? So everybody has tried in their way. So every group has their own observations like this. And out of that, they have evaluated, analyzed and they have given. So the level 1 and level 2 was the best one. The teacher has given, that is. And they have created. So they themselves have divided it, ma'am. This one is easy. This one is difficult. So they have given the levels to the...
Yeah. So here is the way they have evaluated designs. First, in the level 1, 2 mirrors used to hit the target. And in the level 2 again, 3 mirrors,
and level 2 was 4 mirrors. So they have evaluated the designs, and these are the designs created by the students by applying laws of reflection.
So after completing this activity, as usual, we are giving the assignments. So there is an assessment worksheet given, so where some questions given, and we found almost like out of 120, it's 112, near about 112 students have attempted without any help, and the other 8 or 9 students were completed the activity with the help of their peers. Like, this teacher interference was not there, so they themselves had done it within the group.
So during this project, we tried to enhance the following competencies, which include pattern recognition, in which students were engaged and they observed relationship between angle of incidence and angle of reflection. And then decomposition, the maze, the mirror maze was broken down into smaller chunks, manageable steps, and then abstraction and data analysis. So here this project fostered on 21st century skills, which basically revolved around problem solving, critical thinking, and collaboration among the students.
So challenges and opportunity. So I have taken this worksheet because when I was teaching, I was planning to teach this. So it was like, do something different in the classroom so that the class become more interesting. So I found this worksheet from the school buddies, right? And then because there are a lot of elements given, out of that I have chosen some of the elements to implement in, because that was the first time and it is for me also a little difficult and challenging. How can I apply it? So I have just removed some parts, and only few parts I have attempted. So acceptance of new method, like I tried it, and then when I'm trying telling the students that when the student knows the teacher is not going to help, they find it's not possible to do. Right, so this was the one challenge, and designing mirror maze, like it, like for second, third attempt was like, ma'am, it's not possible. So, but like I have to be ready, because every time when they are saying I need to try it out a different way, then I can give them the clues, and that way, like, you know, the complete patience, guidance, and regular continuous trial and error methods we can able to achieve. So these are the two challenges, and the opportunity is like by applying this kind of ways we can foster the 21st century skill, which is the current need exactly. And the best part is that 7th standard we found little difficult when we are taking it in a classroom teaching, but there isn't one Avishkar science exhibition is happening in everywhere, it is happening. So there I tried this, my 7th standard student, to prepare a 5th standard student for the same maze for the presentation. And it was so good, like the 5th standard students, when they have done this maze, they know the actual positioning on the day of setup. They simply, this is placing there, this is placing there, this. So it was really interesting. Then I said, yes, when we apply it and when we practice it more, it is more easier to implement in the classroom. There are many scope. As I said, I have picked up few of the things, but there are many scope, like more variations can be created by restricting number of mirrors, by fixing the position of object and the location of the image to be obtained, by changing the angles. Then you can create the shape patterns like square, triangle, okay. And then integrating the science with like geometry, the angles and all. Thank you. The time is over. Last.
Thank you, slide. That's okay. Yeah. Thank you, everyone, for patient listening.
Maybe one quick question.
Question, then you say example. हम वो पहले के ज़माने में राज्य महाराजों के जो
मिला
होते थे, मिला में ये यूज़ करके वो हम बच्चों को वो example दे सकते हैं, बड़े बड़े example.
It's very simple to teach. Like if you are saying ki why we are spending a lot of time in teaching, just reflection of light. But it has many applications from Archimedes to now only. Yes. Like everywhere you are getting an example. So they actually understand ki yes, this simple law is applicable in many ways. So this is what the advantage. Thank you so much.
Last one is online. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So the last. Thank you. So the last talk is online, and. So it is Parvati from Global Public School talking about CT for professional development of teachers.
So, yeah, so I think the speaker. Speaker is online, so if anybody has any questions, but you should speak into the mic, so just let me know and I'll come with the mic.
Hi. So it was a very interesting presentation. Just wondering how often do you think teachers should undergo these kinds of experiences or discussions or training, whatever?
She suddenly disappeared. She was Parvati.
Parvati, are you there?
Parvati? I see now the... she's there. In the middle, but... Parvati, can you hear us?
You're on mute.
Did you hear the question? We can still can't hear you. One second.
No, we can't hear you.
We're not able to hear you for some reason. Yeah. Did you hear the question?
The camera sound is off, so I can't hear you.
Oh, so now this sound. Okay, so. Okay, so I'll ask the question again.
Is this good? All right, thank you for the very nice presentation. I just wanted to ask, what frequency do you think is, how often do teachers undergo these trainings? How often do teachers undergo these training programs?
We have twice in a week, we have one session for exclusively for the teachers. And then we have
sounds great. Thank you.
Okay. Anything else? Any other questions?
Am I audible?
Yeah. Yes. Thank you. Okay, thank you. So we are done. I don't know if there are any announcements. Neelara, do you have any announcements? We have certificates to distribute, yeah.
Are they in order? We could just call them out.
Yeah.
So
all presenters, please come and receive your certificates. I'll call you out, but you know who you are. Raja Azad. Brajendra Singh Yadav. I'm just calling out, then I'll hand over in a more peaceful fashion. Aarti Sahu, Shivjit Singh, Shyam Tiwari, Upendra Pal, Vishal Naik, Archana, Namrata Zarutkar, Anita Vankhede, Deepa Sharma, and Sunita Maurya. So now we'll hand them out. So first, Raja?
Sir, full name Raja Bhadukshan Singh.
Okay, then we'll change it. One second. Okay?
Thank you.
Thank you. Brajendra Singh Yadav? Thank you. Aarti Sahu. Shivjit Singh. Shyam Tiwari.
Upendra Pal. Ek minute. Vishal Naik.
Thank you, sir.
Archana. Namrata. Okay. Anita. Deepa. Sunita. Thank you so much.
Three to four, we have the demo of the posters. So request you all to kindly go to each and every stall there, have a look at the demos. And after that, 4 to 4:30 is the tea break. And then we assemble in the hall one. Thank you. Thank you very much.